this hole is going to be the most perfect hole in the universe.
Big day in history. It's perfect.
So, you know, we as humans, we've kind of lost this concept that we're actually nature.
Sweating. Sweating hard. Sweating real hard. Plant a tree to save the planet. This is what I hear from every corner. Trees are great. They produce oxygen. So the more we have, the better for the planet, right? Well, it's not as easy as that. Actually, not all trees are great for environment. And the most important thing is not just planting, it's keeping the tree alive. Stick around as we're taking you behind the greens of real carbon offsetting, tree planting, and difference-making project, Renature Monchique.
In this video, together with you, we will be reforesting the area that was severely damaged by fire in Monchique, Portugal, learning about fires, recovery, climate change, and nature, hearing stories of ecologists, scientists, and locals who are collaborating under one goal, reviving our planet, while of course, still having a little fun in nature.
The Renature Monchique project for me is an essential project because it's the opportunity to link the society of this area, the people who own the land, and help them understand or recover the natural elements that have been destroyed by the fire. There's a story about this, and the story is about people and nature, and how we can be in harmony with each other and how we can do some kind of recovery.
The Renature Monchique is a project that aims to restore and reforest area in Portugal that experienced one of the worst wildfires in its history. It raged for a week, burning over 27,000 hectares of land and incinerating 74 houses and residences. Extreme temperatures were, of course, the cause of the fires.
This is an area where the project had started working before the fire, which came in August of 2018. It burnt around 18,000 hectares. So where we're standing right now, I stood a week after the fire and this place was black.
Yeah, we first came here about 2 years ago, which is 1 year after the fire. And to be honest, it was pretty sad because we were cutting up all the black wood, all the burnt trees for a friend for firewood. And every day we would just be coated in black, and then you look around and it was just nothing but black.
Climate change is, of course, the cause of all these fires, but not just in this area, in the whole world.
It's very sad every time you remember that. We had no rain this year. We should have started already picking. There's nothing to pick now. It's too hot. The fruits are not ready to pick.
As the global temperature rises, the planet experiences extreme weather events. In some places, extremely hot and long summers, and in other places, extremely cold and long winters.
This area is severely damaged by drought. This time last year, it was already rainy season, but today it is still 29 degrees and we are sweating while planting trees.
So imagine how hot it must be for them.
Look at it all over there. Vegetation, no vegetation, no vegetation, no vegetation, no vegetation. Look at it. This is almost comparable to a desert.
And all those changing events, uncertain conditions and droughts, making sure that tree grows big and strong needs a lot of care and attention. But luckily, Renature Monchique does exactly that.
This is a reforestation project, but it's also a social aspect of the intervention we do here, because it's not just about planting trees. We have to work with the communities and work together to make these mountains, Serra de Monchique, a nice place to live again and recover nature from all the bad conditions and the fires that destroy these areas.
Carbon offsetting is a way to compensate for your emissions by funding a project that saves carbon dioxide elsewhere. Both individuals and corporations can invest in carbon offset programs. The Renature Monchique project is also a carbon offset partner of Ryanair. By contributing funds to this project, Ryanair is able to offset tons of carbon and help revive the severely damaged area. In 2019, Ryanair and its customers contributed 250,000 euros to Monchique tree planting project.
Carbon offsetting as a concept has its value if we are at the same time trying to reduce carbon on the other side. We have to change our whole economic system, first of all, because the economic system is driven on producing carbon, and we have to change our mindsets on what we are actually trying to achieve. We need to stop just thinking about trees. We need to think about ecosystems. We were built from fire, and here we are terrified of the thing. We try to control it instead of understanding it and working with it. Our human use of land and the way we do things is creating the fire. See, we have put all the wood, the components of the fire into place, and climate change just adds that little spark. And when the spark comes in, this increasing climate, the lack of moisture in the air, the lack of moisture in the ground, then just aggravates that whole process. The greatest challenge in fighting climate change, getting everybody to think the same way. At the moment, we are not doing this. We are taking everything we can lay our hands on, and we are creating a system that is changing the environment for our future generations. But it's the social element that's going to make the politicians think. Where are our big polluters? Who are they, and what are they doing to contribute to fighting the challenge that we have? Look for monoculture. Look for, are they planting species that are appropriate to that area, or are they just planting a plantation? So many of the carbon offsetting projects have been caught out. They are just planting trees. So what they're really doing is putting plantations that they can't put in Europe, they're putting them in Africa somewhere. Are the local people involved? Land is their life. And in many instances, it is just taken away from them.
Planting indigenous trees, trees that benefit locals and community economically, should always be a priority. Showing locals economical benefit in helping nature, showing them the way how to harvest nature's goods in a sustainable and fruitful way that leaves them with more yield, happy nature, and more money. Collaboration between local landowners and reforesting project is an important part of the process. Landowners need to see the benefit in profiting from the land again in order for the reforestation project to begin. So a reforestation project should offer landowners something indigenous that is good for local ecosystem and something that brings money. Here in Monchique, they plant 7 types of trees, and we were lucky to participate in planting and seeing the process of 2 of them, cork oak tree and strawberry tree.
Did you know that planting trees is not the easiest process? Have you ever planted a tree yourself? Share your thoughts in the comments. I would love to hear about your experience.
The process of planting trees is not easy, and it changes all the time based on the place, conditions, species of the tree, and of course, past failures. The team works around the clock preparing the place for planting before the rain season arrives. They clear out the area from other vegetation, which has been proven to provide less competitive environment for trees to grow. They also dig out the holes for trees, which is probably the most challenging process of it all. They also put bamboo sticks in the places to mark the plantings, and of course the final step is putting the tree in the ground.
Yeah, it's a big day in history. I'm about to plant my first cork oak tree in Monchique. Yes, let's do it. Oh yes, boy, nice and strong. Give babies. So this area will be green and healthy and bring monies to communities. Yes! My first tree! I love it.
The cork offers a huge habitat for bees and what we call the European wasp. And over time, the tree becomes weakened because you keep removing its protective layer. The fire would kill this tree without its skirt. With a skirt on, this tree can resist the fire. What is the impact of the fire? Mm-hmm. It has an incredible social impact. Ecologically, if the system is okay, nature will come back. The concept is called resilience. Once you've recovered the oak tree, everything that is associated with the oak tree starts to come back. So the birds, the bees.
RENATURE MONCHIQUE monitors and does research on the growth of trees, success of the process, and changes in the ecosystem throughout the whole process, while landowners do the necessary maintenance and upkeeping of the land. Landowners are able to profit on the harvest of those indigenous trees, like cork or a local traditional spirit.
So we're here now trying the traditional drink, and this is one of the main reasons why the strawberry trees are being planted. This is a secondary drink. So the first drink is called Madronio, and apparently it's very strong. So we're trying the version that has honey in it, and this one is called Meloza. Okay, so, and I'm gonna give it a taste. That's nice. So landowners lend their land to reforestation projects and they plant strawberry trees. Landowners are then benefiting by using the trees to produce local traditional spirit. Another biggest problem of this area is not just drought, it's also eucalyptus. Before coming to Portugal, I didn't know that eucalyptus here is actually kinda evil. Well, it's not the eucalyptus itself, because it's pretty great. It smells great, it grows really fast, and it doesn't need anything to grow. It's the fact that it doesn't belong here because it is coming from Australia.
With the intervention of man into the system, bringing other species that have far more rapidity for fire, like eucalyptus and the Australian acacias, and the impact that we've created by reducing the diversity of species, we have accelerated the ability for this area to burn.
Because it came from different conditions, it quickly adapted in the way that it became aggressive. It outcompetes other trees and doesn't let local ecosystem to flourish. And there are a lot of eucalyptus trees in Portugal. Forest farmers love how fast it grows and how quickly you can sell it. They plant hectares and hectares of trees to quickly cut it down to produce paper and toilet paper without realizing the huge problem. Those trees do not belong in this ecosystem and they're kicking out local flora and fauna.
You cannot put your problem out there and say, look at me, I'm a good guy, I'm busy planting millions of trees. Then go and have a look what they're planting. And in many instances, they're planting the same forests they've got in Europe because they need the product. So they're not planting indigenous forests.
Visiting behind the scenes of this project was really eye-opening for me. I had no idea just how much work, planning, research, communication goes into planting trees and how complicated is the process of making those trees grow strong. Also considering the nature in this area is under threat because of us, humans. Looking at some trees that are surviving and doing well while growing literally on a slope in rocks, how do they do it? That just proves that if nature wants to survive, it will survive. And after the drought comes the rain, and we can start seeing the process of recovery. Nature basically has exactly what is needed to heal itself. Nature has all the answers we need, and we humans only start to understand that now and learn how to use that knowledge to help nature and ultimately ourselves. We start learning that we need to plant trees that are even more resilient in those conditions, like strawberry tree that can come back from ashes after any fire, or cork oak tree that will likely to survive the fire as well thanks to the thick protective bark. All we have to do is get together, switch on our forward thinking, discuss solutions, learn from our mistakes, and do better each time in tree planting, in business, in everyday life.
So the solution is to show locals and tree farmers that there is more economical, social, and environmental benefit in planting indigenous trees.
proper tree planting offsetting project isn't just about planting trees. It is about helping to regrow the forest, revitalize property owners, and give big corporations a way to reduce their greenhouse gas emissions by investing in projects like that.
This is my life. I think I was born an ecologist. I scared the living daylights out of my mother because I brought everything that was living home. Whether it was going to bite them or sting them, it didn't matter to me. We need that collective of young people who actually understand what the problem is, not just to react to something, but understand the issue. And the issue is that we are locked into a system that is not going to change unless they are forced to change. We as humans, we've kind of lost this concept that we're actually nature. You know, we've kind of created a world for ourselves. But at the end of the day, without water, without potable water, water we can drink, clean air and fertile soils, we can do nothing. From a human perspective, we are destroying these ecosystems, the very ecosystems we need to keep us alive. You just said it's awareness, it's understanding the systems, it's education. For me, primarily, it's the political system isn't open enough to allow this kind of discourse.
They're scared of losing money, right? Because money is the biggest drive. They're scared of changing into this new system that is not so much confirmed yet, is not proven to be sustainable. The biggest focus is economical, is to show that the system not just works in a sustainable manner, but is also profitable. Profitable for those governments, for those organizations, for those businesses and companies. So they're like, oh, we can be good for the planet and make more money because we're pleasing the customers more. Yes, I'm gonna do that, and maybe I'll invest more into it. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It will really help us grow and create more videos like that and educate more people on those positive environmental topics. We're so extremely thankful that we were able to see behind the scenes work of this real carbon offsetting project. And most importantly, we were able to learn so much about the process, nature and ecology, and it was our huge pleasure to share this information with you. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. Your support means everything to us. And of course, if you have an idea that you think might be perfect for Behind the Greens concept, let us know in the comments or using an email that I left in the description box. Thank you so much for being part of this journey, and I'll see you next week behind the greens of even more exciting project. Thank you for watching. Bye.